Evelyn, you're a pace setter. Precious, good to see you. And today we have Ian. Please, Ian, nani, Eve. Tangaza kwa group, today it's Ian. Thank you, Rodrigo.
Hata dino lito dongo angekwenda hata jua iwake wake si ndio
jua ingekuwa zima hiyo microphone yako ujoi. The microphone, Omera. Any group leaders in this house?
Yes, we are.
Yeah, how is your group doing? Mko ready? Maybe go ahead and tell me the progress you have. What's your progress like, Maybe? Maybe, you're seated like you want to talk to us. Tell us, kama kuna progress kwa rupi yenu ama.
In terms of the African song?
Yeah, not African song, everything you're preparing as a group.
Yes, there is, because we are already in groups and the groups are already working on their verses. As far as the bios are concerned, I have some few who have sent their videos. I'll push those who have not yet to send so that we can edit them.
What's happening? Remember, I said this time I want very fine videos, very, very well done videos, okay?
Yes.
So I hope you're going all the way, yeah?
Yeah, we've insisted on quality.
Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. I think I've already seen one video from Denisiel.
Yes.
It's impressive, impressive.
She's really set the pace.
She's lucky because her brother is actually, her brother owns a TV station. An online TV station. So if you have people who are like that, that helps us in profiling, you know? Yeah, that's a good thing for us. That's a plus. So well done. Yeah. Incidentally, I'm like in 3 meetings now. But Aina Shida, these days you can operate like an octopus. Ian, thank you very much for coming. I was actually finishing up another meeting, but thank you. I want to hand in the meetings.
You're most welcome. Asante sana.
Yeah, so that was my boss. I was finishing up. Yeah, so Ian, karibu sana. Not these people have never seen you.
Yes. That bit is ongoing. And I think we should be able to make it a little easier this time because the group is fewer. Yeah. Yes, Ian.
Yes.
Yeah, costume and everything is allowed. Yeah. So these guys are expecting a lot from you, Ian. And they know you. I told them Ian is very time conscious. They were here 30 minutes before you came. So, and so they really, really are hungry to hear what you're going to tell them. We hope that's milk you're taking and not soda. You always talk about choice of song. You always talk about, you know, choice of song is okay, but then how do you prepare for 2 minutes? Because the most we can give them online is 2 minutes. So go ahead and tell them so much that you know that they you have an hour between now and 2 p.m. If you want
that's
to
a
extend,
long
you can
time.
Extend just.
No.
Yeah.
I'm going to talk for 10 minutes, then I'm going to open it up for questions.
Okay, that's another way that you can handle this, yeah. So
yes.
They've only seen you judging, and this time we don't want them to just see you judging, so that before you start judging them, they will be aware of what your expectation is, so that they can be able to match, and so that we can also be able to give quality out there. They've just been doing quite a lot, probably just before question time, they will give you a brief of what they've been doing to prepare. Now, this is a group that is holistic. This time we're preparing them holistically, and they will explain to you how holistic this has been so that you know what other avenues they've been able to express their gifting. Over to you, Ian. You know, Ian from Tasker Project Fame. Ian, we have people from South Sudan. Yeah, I love the laugh. We also have somebody from Nigeria. We have some people from Cameroon, but the Cameroonians went into the training shift. There are some people we have taken to what we call Wasomi because of the toughness of this competition. They are not able to cope up, so we take them to the Wasomi group. That way, nobody judges them if they're not able to produce as competitors. They become now trainees, all right? So we also have Burundi and Congo in the house. So sometimes if you use English, don't use very, very complex ones because Congolese and Burundians speak French. You can use a little French, you know? Yes, yeah. So.
Okay.
I've never seen you laugh, so thank God you can laugh.
My first question is, I can only see Mbaire Kamau. That's the only person I can see. Have you asked all of them, the rest, including yourself, to put up their videos?
Technically, sometimes if you put all screen, no.
I will also put my video off. So that we're all alike, I'll put my video off.
Ah, that's okay. In this class, it's okay even if your video is off, Ian. So
yes.
This hour, sometimes it interferes
with
the
boring
with the network. I know, we have to see your faces, but only when they're going to answer questions, that's when you see their videos on. Or, if it's
no,
too much,
no.
It can go off. Yes.
My first request is that I see who I am talking to. So everyone, put your video on.
Guys, put your videos on. I hope they're with you.
Everybody who can hear me, put your video on. Once I see everybody, I will start. I don't talk to pictures. I don't talk to photographs. That is not how I do my teaching. And if you're wearing a mask, please take it off your chin. It does not help you. Either put it on properly or remove it kabisa. Not protecting or hiding your double chin. Princess Yuri, Christine, Adhiambo. G, who's just connecting, I need to see you. Yvette, wave, you're so still. I don't know whether that's a photograph. Yvette Mbotella, Yvonette Mbotella, that's. Okay, Yvonette, rotate so that you're not hanging on the wall. Thank you. Good. I've been doing online teaching since the schools closed. And one of the things that is a must is that the students must put their videos on, because that way I know that they are there. They could just put their videos off and take off. And there I am talking to myself. That's why I do need to see who I am talking to. Right, now, for this competition, you've got 2 minutes. 2 minutes is a very, very short time to give your very best. And it's also a very long time when you have not done your homework. And I don't think I'm going to say anything new that you've not heard me say before. Choice of song is most important. What kind of song are you choosing? Is it a song that shows off your voice or your vocal skills in a very short time? Or is it something that's got a bit of singing at the beginning, then so much instrumental, and we really don't get to hear you sing? Is it one that keeps repeating itself, repeating, repeating, repeating? If you're repeating, it's got to be different. And it doesn't even have to start at the beginning. You could decide to start at the chorus. You could decide to start, you could do chorus, do bridge, modulate, just make it as different as you can. Remember, you need to impress me within, because I'm talking for myself. I don't know what the other judges are, I don't know what the other judges look for. But within 7 seconds, I can almost determine whether I will listen to the rest of it or switch off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is enough for me to know whether you've done your homework or not. And the fact that you are not going to be doing it live, at least I hope you will not think you can do this live, because live will not work. This will be recorded. So you've got a chance to record it, watch it yourself, get somebody else to look at it, listen to it carefully, and decide whether this is good enough to submit or you're going to do it again. Live, you cannot do that. And if you try and do it live, and there's no way you're going to be in sync. No way. Your network might decide to give you issues. Then what happens? Because I can only judge what I see and what I hear. You cannot tell me, oh no, today I had problems with my network. I really don't sound as bad as this. I'm really good. I'm sorry. It is what is put in front of me that I am going to judge. Now, let's look at choice of song. Are you going to pick on something that everyone knows and is going to compare you with the original? Or are you going to pick a song that not many people know and you do it really, really well? Those are things that you need to consider. I would avoid the really popular songs unless you're going to turn it completely different and make it your own. Because if you pick a popular song, very many people have done it. Very many people have heard it. Chances are I will have heard it, and I will have heard many versions, many covers. And sorry, I will compare you to all the others I have heard. And because it is your choice, it is not somebody else who has given you a song to sing. At least I hope that's how it's going to be. It's going to be your choice. Pick something that you know you can really own. Even if it's a known, well, not very common song, but somebody knows it, they say, I know that song, but the way you've done it, it's completely different, a completely new song. Picking a song by John Legend, All of Me, and then you do it exactly like he does it. Sorry, that's not impressive. That is not impressive. I would challenge you, if you are a girl, pick a man's song. That way you are unlikely to try and do it like the man did it. If you're a guy, pick a lady's song. Then that way you have to do a lot of homework. You've got to make sure that you are doing it in a way that nobody else has done and in a way that shows off your voice. Pick something that does not have too much instrumental music in it. No matter how good your band is, don't start saying, okay, now, drummer, it's you. Okay, guitar solo, keyboard. No. I will be looking at you. I will be listening out for your singing. The instruments complement your singing, not the other way around. So I must have your voice in my face and the instruments at the background. The most important person is you. The most important instrument is your voice. And I've said it before, if you pick something that repeats itself, then make sure you either modulate or do it in a different way. There are some very popular songs, but they really don't go anywhere. They really don't go anywhere. After the first verse and the chorus, that's it. So after barely 45 seconds, that's it. It doesn't have anywhere else to go. So choice of song, very, very, very important. Then you need to have done this song over and over and over again with your band so that you are tight and you have timed it to last 2 minutes, no more, no less. That's a lot of work. That is a lot of work. And you've got to know who's doing BGVs and what they are doing and how they are complementing your singing, how they're giving you background vocals. You can start off with the background vocals, I don't mind. But once you come in, I need to hear you right from the time you come in right to the end. Don't give somebody else a chance. You are the one who is being judged. Then how you perform it, dress the part. Dress the part. If you are going to dance or move about, make sure the dancing does not take away from your singing. If it does, then I suggest you go and enter a dance competition instead. I'm not going to sit here watching you dance when I should be listening to you sing. Stop singing, go to the dance competition. If it's got dancing, you can have dancers and you can move, just move a bit, that's fine. I don't mean you just stand there like a pole. No, enjoy yourself. And you'll have had to talk with your camera person to know what to focus on. And I really wish they would focus mainly on you. So choose whether you're going to be like that or whether it's going to be the fool when you're moving about. Microphone, if you're going to use a microphone, is it going to be on a stand or are you going to hold it? If it's on a stand, fine. But if you decide to take it out of the mic stand, get rid of the mic stand. Don't have a microphone stand without, and you're holding the mic and the microphone stand is still in front of you. And I talked about dressing. First impressions, very important. As soon as you're on, before you start singing, people are seeing. And people find it easier to see than to listen. It's always easier to see than to listen. If I start doing this, you will start wondering, oh gosh, what is going on? And you will stop listening to what I'm saying and just wonder, what is he doing? It is easier to see than to listen. So dress the part. Take some effort to dress up. You've put in so much work. It'll be such a pity for you to come on looking like you've just woken up or walked out of some bar. Take some time. Look in front of that mirror and say, yes, I like what I see. Okay. I will open it up now for questions. Open for questions now. And let's do it in an order. If you want to, if you're asking a question, just do this, and I will call you, unmute, ask your question. No questions, so you've understood. Okay then, we might as well say goodbye.
And pulisa moto, bwana. Relax. You're too harsh. Guys, you ask your questions.
No questions? Aya, that's fine.
You can type it on the whatever if you're afraid to ask. Ian, these are performers. If you can say something about performing, apart from just what you mentioned, mic dynamics,
the problem is, I don't know what they want to know. And the only way I can find out what they want to know is if they ask questions.
Yeah.
So I am not saying anything else. If I don't get questions, then I will assume that's it. And we end this session. Let's not waste time. Whether you find me Kali or not, that's how I am.
I have a question. Mbaire Kamau.
Mbaire, go ahead.
Okay. The thing you've talked about, choice of song, is this in general context or is it only as it regards this competition?
Whenever you are going into an audition for any music competition, any audition for music, choice of song is always important.
Okay, thank you.
Because you cannot say, I have other songs. No, you give your best and you give your best within the first 30 seconds. Somebody should have said, oh, okay, let me hear more. But if you start thinking you're going to warm up, you might just be told, thank you, that's it. That's it. I'm not gonna waste my time listening to somebody as they warm up and as they just getting ready. I'm getting ready. Na 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 na. Daritanjerano, sio aringa murango. No, 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 no. You come in immediately, bang. And people get their attention. Don't warm up to it. No. Bang. Answered Mbaire?
Yes, thank you so much.
Okay. That example is like, you can see Kikuyu very well.
Ian, kumbe unajua Kikuyu.
Can we have questions? Anyone yes. Comments, please? Thank you.
Yes, I have a question.
Please, who are you?
This is Catherine.
Okay, I cannot even see you. Sorry, I don't have my specs. Go ahead, Catherine.
Catherine Carrero.
Okay, I see you now. Go ahead.
Okay, my question is, suppose you have not burnt, is it okay to use a recorded instrumental? Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay.
But you've got to edit it to 2 minutes. It cannot have such a long intro. If it's a track that already has a long intro, like 4-10 seconds, cut it, edit it so that it gives you the key and the beat, and you know when to come in. Because you can't say, you know, you're there waiting for it to start so that you come in. No, edit it so that it lasts 2 minutes. You know exactly when to start, exactly when to finish. Absolutely.
I also have a question.
Go ahead, Princess.
Okay, thank you. In this situation, can somebody use original? My own composition, I mean.
That's tricky. That is tricky. You can, but it's a very big risk. Unless it's a really good song. A really, really good song. I would avoid doing anything original.
Okay, thank you.
Next.
Christine here, I have a question.
Go ahead, Christine.
So I wanted to know, must we have backup vocals, or we can just like do the song solo?
It is not necessary. It's not necessary. It's just like it's not necessary to have a band if you've got the backing track. You don't even need a whole band if you've got somebody to accompany you on guitar or piano. It's just to help you. Those are additions, but it doesn't mean that you have to have BGVs. Not all songs have BGVs. And if you're going to have BGVs, background vocalists, who just say, once, waste of time.
Okay, remember another question.
Sorry to cut you short, Christine. The fewer people you're working with, the better. Just remember that. Fewer is better. It is much easier to rehearse with a pianist or a guitarist than a whole band. Because musicians are terrible when it comes to timekeeping. They have egos. So you'd rather have somebody on a keyboard or one person on guitar. It is easier to rehearse. Unless, of course, you've already been working with a band, then that's fine. But the fewer people accompanying you, the better for you. Sorry, go ahead to your second question.
Okay. Does the choice of the song also depend on our voice textures? Like, there are those people who are low singers or high singers. Can, for example, if you are female and you already told us we can do male songs, it will help to bring out our voices. So can I choose, for example, a male who sings high or a male who sings low?
No. It's not necessary. A few stolen moments is all that we share. You've got your, that's a Whitney Houston song. Am I singing it like her up there? No. Mm. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
Hello. Yeah, so you're picking a song by a male, but you're putting it into the key that is comfortable with you. Okay. Next.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, speak, yeah.
Hello, this is Joyce.
Go ahead, Joyce.
My questions have been asked, but not completely. I wanted to find out if it is possible just to go completely unaccompanied, and if it is okay to kind of do all the voices on your own, like using an app.
That's very tricky. Very, very tricky. It's doable, yes, but it'll take a lot of work. And wow, no, that's too much hard work. Because if you just imagine you're doing four parts, you're doing soprano, alto, tenor, bass, or whatever. So you've recorded alto, tenor, and bass, because what you have to be singing is the melody. That takes a lot. That takes a lot. And then it's got to be something that you can perform somewhere else. Does that make sense, Joyce?
Yes, it does to some extent. So I want to understand that one of the requirements for this 2-minute video should be that we have background vocals. So I cannot sing on my own.
You can record the, if there are oohs and ahs that you've recorded, that's fine. That's fine. But, it's doable, but it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. And you need to ask yourself, will it really make the song, make your presentation better? If you think it will, hey, go ahead. Do it, try it, let somebody with a critical ear listen to it and tell you whether that's necessary or not. Okay.
It's Mbaire again.
Go ahead.
I'd like to ask a question on behalf of Shiko, whose audio is not working, and she's asking, can someone consult with the judges to find out what style best suits them?
I don't know whether Helen allows that. I don't know.
Yes, I do. I do allow that, yeah.
But if that is allowed and you want me to help you out, I am more than willing. More than willing.
I thought he was going to say, I am not going to do that.
Helen, I'm going to put you on mute full time now and unmute you only when I need you. If you need my help, I am absolutely available. We can sort that out. It is important for you to give your best. If you give a performance and you know that that was not your best, then you've really wasted time. Any more questions?
Yeah, there's another one from Christina Viambo. I think she has technical problems. Nahicha, I kick ups. She says another question can be, can we do the song in the studio?
And played, then send it played. That's fine. As far as I'm concerned, that is fine. Provided that you have not used auto-tune. provided that it is you actually singing. Not that you've recorded it and then you're just coming to open your mouth like you're singing. You recorded it, you are off, you did, the engineer was very good and auto-tuned it really well, and now all you're doing is no. It must be a live recording, if I can put it that way. Live recording.
Good afternoon, sir. Can I ask a question?
Sorry, go ahead. You're breaking whoever you are.
Okay, my name is Ustaz.
Go ahead.
Okay, I listened to you. Thank you so much, sir, for the enlightenment and...
Sorry. You're really breaking up. Please type your question. Either okay, speak slowly or type your question, because you're really breaking up.
Okay, let me type.
Please type it. Please type it.
Ejidia, you're silent. Next.
Anybody else?
Hi, I'm Ray Kinemia.
Go ahead.
I would like to ask a question.
Please do.
How many people are supposed to listen to your song before you bring it out to a larger audience?
I don't understand.
I mean, like, you've recorded a song and you feel like you've done your best and the producer has done their best, but then there's someone who thinks it's not okay and now you're confused because maybe you've worked with the best producer, maybe in the market or something. So how many people should you let listen to your music without jeopardizing the project?
I would say 2 or 3, but don't let what they tell you be gospel truth. Get 2 or 3 different people who have a critical ear. Don't ask your friends, don't ask your family. They will cheat you and tell you it's beautiful. It's the best thing they have heard since Samba Mapangale. Get 3 independent people and then just listen to their comments. But doesn't mean that if one tells you, you should have done this, you should have done that, that you're going to do it. No, just take their opinion. But the ultimate end of it is you. The person who will decide is really you. So 2 or 3 people, that's it. Not family, not friends. Okay,
thank you.
Let me see. Iyamu's, did he write his question?
There's a question from Fazla saying, what about diction? What exactly do we look for? Where she's actually thinking that sometimes less is more. So what about diction? Why do people strain with diction?
As long as we can understand what you're saying, I don't mean that you have to do this. I don't have to talk like this for you to understand what I am saying. Does that make sense? Then on the other hand, you just can't...
Speak like a Raila Odinga. It's just a basic game to watch.
You're so stupid like this, and we got to understand. Genuine!
Speak with your head.
See, my giving me Let's hear what you're saying, especially since I've noticed that most of you are doing gospel. Now, gospel is passing the message on to somebody. If they can't hear what the message is, then it's pointless. If it sounds really nice, what language am I singing in? You can't tell. Okay, that's an example. Then I don't mean, oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, my power throughout the universe displayed.
That is the way we display this soul in Luwo.
Let's hear what you're singing about. I wouldn't say less is more, but just be careful about how you're singing. Let people know what you're singing about. Iyamu says, I have been in a few auditions where I was told most times it is not okay to do a known song by an opposite sex, especially when you don't have the required pitch. But you have disagreed with that from one of your answers. What is the balance? I think I explained that when I took a few stolen moments is all that we can share. That is Whitney Houston's song in her pitch. Okay? And I won't be able to do it in her pitch that well. Take it down. A few stolen moments is all that we share. That's what I meant. That is what I meant. I didn't mean you take a woman's song and start doing it in the same pitch as she does. No. Yamu, does that answer your question? Just give me a thumbs up or not. I see no more. Any other questions? Princess, yes. Are you clapping? Oh. Go ahead.
Okay, so my name is David from Kenya, and I was asking, what will you classify as an outstanding performance?
Somebody who has stage presence, somebody who has worked on their song really, really well, who is singing in a very comfortable range. They've not pitched it too high or pitched it too low, and they have picked the right song that shows off their voice, and somebody who's enjoying their performance, that is an outstanding performance. After 2 minutes, I'm saying, what? Is that all? Come on, I needed to hear more. That is it. That I really want to hear more from this person. That is an outstanding performance.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
Okay, now that you have said we should do songs that from the opposite sex, does it mean that we can't do a song by same sex at all? And then,
Mayo.
How?
I can't hear you.
No, it's okay. No, I was suggesting. So okay. That if you're, yes, it'll make you work harder. Please, I'm not saying all girls pick men's songs and all boys pick girls' songs. No, I was suggesting a way of ensuring that you don't copy what the original sounds like. It was a suggestion. Okay. I have not said you have to do it. No.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Christine, yeah, I was also asking.
Go ahead.
Go ahead, Christine.
What about the dressing? What about the dressing? Do we have to dress according to the, maybe if the song is an African song, do we have to dress in a certain way that, you know, depicts what is being spoken in the song, or should we just dress smartly for any song?
How many songs are you doing? How many songs are you doing, Christine? For the competition, how many songs are you doing? Sorry? How many?
I don't know. I have not been told yet.
Okay. Dress appropriately. Dress appropriately. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay, thank you.
Iamu, you're saying that you didn't hear Ian's answer. Ian just basically say that you pitch yourself according to your voice. Be comfortable with the range. You don't have to do it in high pitch. Just get the right pitch for your voice and then go ahead and you know, display your voice.
Anybody else? I can't believe you guys don't have questions.
Okay. I have another question.
Please go ahead.
So what is the most common mistake that you have noted that most performing artists make when performing?
Wrong choice of song, of course. Wrong choice of song. It can, no matter how good a singer you are, if you get the wrong song, that's it, you're done.
Yes. Yeah.
You're done.
If you understand what comfortability means. Yeah. Ojoey.
Sorry, go ahead, Joyce.
This is Joyce.
No, Joyce, please type your question. Joyce, type your question, please.
Wait on that and just ask. How do you know your physical?
Okay, type
Joyce.
Your question. Your network is bad. Yeah?
Joyce, type your question, please.
Okay, typing.
Anybody else while Joyce is typing?
Yeah, Christine asks a question that I also have. What
Please,
do you what do you consider when you're choosing the right song for you? How do you know a song is right for you?
Do I like it? Is it within my vocal range? Can I hit the high notes and can I hit the low notes? Does it show off my voice? Does it give me a chance to show off? Is it something that I will really enjoy performing? You have to pick the right song. It could be that you love a song, but are you able to do it? And remember, it's not the full song. We're talking about 2 minutes. 2 minutes is a very short time. And it, and like I said before, it can also be a very long time. So it's got to be something that you, a song that you enjoy, something that you feel like it was written for you. It was written for you. And you just love singing it. And everybody has got songs they love. Anybody else?
Ian, so the question from...
how do I make a high tone because I'm a low toner? Why are you going high? Why? Stick to where you're comfortable. Unless you want to go into false. Now, this is clear. Low tones, beautiful when done by a lady. Listen to Cynthia Arrivo. Please write her down. Cynthia Arrivo. Write it down. Yeah, Sioni Mkiandika. Cynthia, I'll write it for you, then you can look at it. Thank you. Thank you, Baire. Cynthia Arrivo. She's got such a beautiful range. What's that song you like doing of Cynthia Arrivo? Stand Up. Just listen to that song. Stand Up. Can I share a video? Woo-wee. Can I share a screen? Helen? Helen? Helen Tawali?
Jajian.
Yes?
I think you can share, yes, you can.
No, I can't. Host disabled participants sharing, and she's disappeared.
Okay, let me look for her then.
Please do, then while I get the video, because I know you guys will not listen to her.
Question, sir.
Go ahead.
Okay. I have a concern, like not really a question, but it's a concern. Like, I do sing very high tones, like high notes. Most yes. of the people tell me that I do very high notes, and okay, fine. I feel comfortable doing them, but I don't know whether it will be okay for me to try it here, because most of the people just tell me it's not. I, like they can't do it, like they don't feel it, but I don't know. I don't, I can't notes.
Tell you what, go ahead and do it here right now.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
Thou shalt not call upon the name of the Lord in vain. Do it now. That Jesus you've called will help you.
Okay, okay. Okay, let me choose a song, please.
Okay, you choose, then when you're ready. Helen! Helen, Helen Akoth with 15 other names, Mtawali, where are you?
Olivia Akoth, Omolo Nyarnyakach, Makine Nakawutu,
please allow me to share screen.
From the participants.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yamu is the host. Right.
Who's the host?
Yeah, please.
Yamu is the host.
Yamu.
Iambu, oh gosh, he can't be the host and he's not here. Yawa. Do you have a co-host?
No, he's there. Iambu. No, 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 you can only do one host here.
Yes, can you please give
here? I need the host to remove. I need to share something, Iambu. So please disable or enable participant screen sharing.
He probably doesn't even know how to do that now.
Yo.
Hey, I wonder who put the host.
Am I the host?
Iambu, yes. Please.
Touch the name of Ian and enable him to be the host. Oh. And you touch it and make him host. Oh.
No problem. I still have a good host, but thank God. Maybe something is happening spiritually.
Make me a co-host then, please.
I know
if we
are within your thing.
You're lonely.
Let me do it.
Uh-uh.
The way you're saying, the way you're saying, it means that you don't even know what it is.
Looking for it now.
Either enable sharing or make me a co-host.
Yeah. But the look of things is inside the matatu.
Oi.
Okay, Yamu, if you can hear, please.
I've made him the host. I've made him the host.
Very good. Okay, I'm going
to
share.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
All right, I am now. Okay.
Mute your mic, Yamu, mute your mic.
Yeah. Listen to the range of my voice.
I've been walking with my face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can when I can, while I can for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it. Sun begins to shine. We're gonna start moving towards that separating line. Oh, I'm waiting through muddy water. You know I gotta make. Way to salvation, and I'll fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Follow us. To face 'cause I'm alone, and I just
Okay. What do you think of that?
Wow.
Did you hear her range when she starts? How low she goes, and then the scream that hits the really high notes. And she doesn't have to move about so much. And you can see that that song means a lot to her. That is a song from the movie, oh gosh, Harriet. Erivo is British, but she was acting as Harriet, an American woman who helped free slaves. And she was the main actress in Harriet, and she also did the theme song. So she's a singer, but she also acts. She's like May. And that is a beautiful performance. Everything was just perfect. The BGVs did not overshadow her. You could hear every single thing she was saying, and she enjoyed herself. And obviously, the audience enjoyed themselves. So the vocal range, if you've got a vocal range like that, show it off. Okay, I don't know whose question I was answering by showing that. Any other questions?
Ian, you are now host of the show.
Thank you. Right, any other questions? How do we show off such range within 2 minutes? She did a verse, chorus, then the modulation. So forget about the first verse. Go straight to the second verse with a chorus, modulate, and go to chorus. That is enough. You can even do it in 1 minute. It's just deciding this is what I'm going to do. So it is very possible to do it. The whole song is three minutes something. I would have been a slave abolitionist if I lived in her time. Whoa. Tip to make sure you get maximum audience retention. Most of the time, if you enjoy yourself, the audience will enjoy themselves. And it's right from the time you step onto that stage. First impressions, very important. You just stand there and you have stage presence. Without you opening your mouth, people are already, oh, okay. In a good way. It's got to be in a good way. Then the moment you open your mouth, it confirms what they're already thinking. So first impressions, confidence without the cockiness. Don't get on there knowing that you are really, really good. No. Confidence.
God's gift to humanity, man.
Confidence, but a controlled confidence. Don't go there being cocky. What other questions? Confidence without cockiness, right? And then making the audience think that you are singing to them. Could you, when she was singing, could you feel that you were the only one in the audience when you're watching her? You were just captivated by her. You even forget about anything else that's happening around you. That is stage presence. And she's already established herself. Please look for all the other things she has done. She is amazing. Anybody else?
Ian, can I read the questions out for you?
Oh, please do.
Okay, so Grace Arch is asking, another question, what happens if your audience is Christian-based and most songs that can showcase your range is a secular song? Whitney Houston, et cetera, et cetera. Another thing, we hear judges say the song is too big for you. What do you do, especially if you are confident about that song? So the first song of, I think the first section is, most Christian-based songs, according to that person, they think it's not, you know, it's not range friendly with regards to being able to explore your range. So answer that one first.
Christian-based post songs that can showcase your range. Then you have not listened to enough.
Exactly.
You have not listened to enough Christian songs. Wow. Hey. Please, just
give examples.
Okay. Now is No. You have to do your homework. You've got to do your homework and look at especially Black American gospel singers. Then you will know the range we are talking about. Do your homework.
And all right.
The other thing I'm going to ask you is, what is one word that sums up Christianity, what Christianity is all about? Just one word.
Okay.
Please, I need answers. One word that sums up Christianity, love. That sums up gospel. Sorry?
Love.
Love. That's it. Love. If you pick a love song, you're safe. And I'm talking about love of agape. Agape love, that's what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about romantic love. Because the gospel, Bible, Christianity is all about love. Now, take the song she was singing. Take my people with me. That could be Moses talking about leading the Israelites, taking the people out of Egypt. Stand up. Stand up. That's the song. It's about taking people out. And that is love. So somebody will be able to relate with that. That's the first part of it. What is the second part?
Sorry. Let me second. The second part was about
The song being too big.
Yeah, the judges who say the song is too big. So what do you do as a performer, as a singer, if you feel you are comfortable with that song, regardless of the fact that they say that song is big?
Okay, I have heard, I've asked people what they're doing, and they tell me a song like, say, by Mariah Carey or Whitney Houston or Luther Vandross. And I think, that song is too big for you. Uh-huh. And there are times when they have done it in a completely different way. And I realize, whoa, you've actually done justice to that song. So that is a risk worth taking if you know that you've done it in a way that nobody else has done it in a good way. In a good way. It could be a challenging song, but you've managed to sort out if it's got very high notes or funny runs, you've managed to do them your own way. So that people still recognize the song, but the way you have done it is completely different.
That's true.
Yes, please go ahead.
Let me see if there are other questions here. Someone is saying, Hallelujah has got Lord, Hallelujah, meaning examples and saying that the song has got ranges. Well, I don't know about that, Ian. Do you think, I don't think Hallelujah has ranges.
I really hate that song. Number one, you need to do your homework about Hallelujah.
Yes,
there was a sacred song that David played and he praised the Lord. You should listen to the original song.
By Lennon.
It is not a Christian song.
That's not a Christian song.
Yeah. I really hate that song. And everywhere you go, I heard there was a sacred God.
Hallelujah.
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 It's not a Christian song.
Avoid that song. And please, I want you to look it up. Look at the original lyrics of that song, Hallelujah. They are, I don't know, they are 50. They're like a Kikuyu hymn, which has 13 verses and 13 choruses. It's long. And it's not really Christian.
It's not a Christian
song. Hallelujah.
In fact, the original song composed by Leonard Cohen has six stanzas, and none of those talks anything about gospel. It's not a gospel song.
But there's Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
No, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, like can the be Congolese, in different platforms. And
Congolese
in also
do that trick where they sing anything. Nakupenda, naona kama umetoka, unatembea. Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
That is the problem we have with our gospel music these days. Most of our so-called gospel music is actually secular.
That's true.
It is got beats that's getting you to dance. And just because they throw in Mungu there and Yesu there and a few verses there, they think they justify it being a gospel Christian song. But they're not. Let me tell you, 80% of the songs that you're listening to, Kenyan gospel, are not. They don't have the message. They've got the nice beat for you to, you know, to dance, but they don't have a message. There are very few gospel Kenyan musicians who are doing proper gospel, a message that they're passing across. Most of them, they get a good Lingala beat, something that you can dance to. They put in funny words and occasionally throw in a verse or whatever to justify it being a Christian song.
I have olfactory kinesics, temporal.
No.
Spatial. Yeah, some people naturally were in class.
I agree with you 100%. I agree with you 100%.
I am glad that
people... Let me see if I can read some other comments from here.
Research on it.
I'm trying to hey, find something.
Now, being on
sorry.
Are we having two meetings? Who is that? No, is that Helen?
Yes, I'm trying to switch a microphone off. There
I go. I'm just... the host. Watch, I kick her out. It's okay. She's muted now. Go ahead.
Yeah. Let me see if I can find any other. Let me see. Someone is saying. Let me see. Oh, I need to brush. Look at this one. She's saying about things. Just because a song mentions God or is Christian, it has Christian language, does not make it gospel as a comment. Princess is saying, would you mind choosing songs for us?
You see, I would need to know you. I need to know your range. I need to know what genre you're good at for me to pick a song for you. Because I don't want to choose, I would not like to choose, especially when it comes to the finals, it would be wrong for somebody to have chosen a song that you don't feel. And then you're literally being forced to sing that song. You will not do it well.
All right.
I wish you had a category where it is judges' choice. And then we just pick songs and give them to you. That way is picking something completely out of your comfort zone. You think you're an R&B singer. I challenge you and give you a reggae song. That's getting you out of your comfort zone and stretching your ability. I don't know. That's going into something else. What songs?
Someone is saying... Now, so at AOV, what songs are we to do, Christian or secular? That's Christine from South Sudan asking.
I think that's your choice. If I'm not wrong, that's your choice.
That's their choice, yeah.
This is not a Christian AOV, is it?
No, it's not.
No, it's just open. Don't be forced to do a Christian song if you don't feel it. No.
I think this one I can answer, but you know, it was meant for you. So let me just ask you. Joyce Ojoey is asking, can I send my choice of songs to you to help me pick out?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Awesome. Wait, Ian, uko kwa group kwanza, uko kwa group ya UV3.
WhatsApp group.
Yeah, a WhatsApp group. Because you know, how will she send the choice of songs if you are not in the group?
She can email it.
Yeah. For those who don't know Ian's email address, please, I know Ian's email address.
I'll type it here for you. I'll type it here. It's very easy.
Sawa, okay, type it. As I look for another comment, okay. Oh, someone is saying, Ian, I already have your number, but you don't respond.
Send me something right now, Joyce, if you have my number, and I'd like to know how you got my number.
Exactly.
Okay.
There you go. Let me see if there's another comment altogether. Here we go. All right, Chico's asking, kind request, can we send, I think she was trying to say, kind request, can we send our songs to the judges so that they can help, you know, tell our range?
Yes.
Okay, then I think that is answered. What we'll do, he's already shared his email, so if you have a song you've done and you'd want Ian to listen to it and to be able to advise you accordingly, he will do exactly that.
Thank you. I have got your message. I don't know how you got my number, but yes.
That's why you look at Joyce's face. He just goes, oh my gosh.
Hey, number yako tunaijua. Ian, we know your number.
Hey, we Joyce.
Yes.
Then there was a competition. I think I can't remember the thing being a competition, and I got the number.
Hey, okay.
Yeah, and people know you much more than you expect. Eh?
Hi. Let me make it. Let me make it fair for everyone then.
Oh, wow. Bora, you don't try to Ian. Ian, I am in a fix. Please send me 1,000 bob. Okay, unmute yourself, Ian. Unmute your mic.
It means, okay, you have my number there. Just send what you're sending and your name. Please don't say hi because I will not respond. Hae, that one I will delete and I will block you.
Even without just looking.
Send your song and please make sure each song is either 1 minute or 2 minutes. In fact, let's make it 1 minute only. No more than 1 minute. And don't say anything else. Just write your name and send the song. Here too.
Submit your song.
1 minute.
All right, guys. Thank you so much. I think that's, let me see if I can, yeah, there you go. All right. So thank you so much. People, Ian doesn't like to be called Judge Ian. It's just Ian Mbugua. So yes. He's called Ian Mbugua. So thank you so much, Ian, for coming through. And we're looking forward to, of course, engaging you every once in a fortnight or so to just be able to help here and there. Thank you so much for your time. Your TV yako inaka poor man. I like Hey,
you
have not seen the lower side of you, brother.
I have not looked at.
Hey, you only come out and say, what?
Let's go and show you the swimming pool, to an anyone swimming pool, and the lounge. Goodbye.
Bye, Ian. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Thank you, guys. Any question? I'm a kanjo, I'm a bigger.